September the 7th, 1940. It was a day that shook the world because Germany turned its warlike attention to England's civilian population to try to break its spirit. The Blitz on London was a new departure. Night after night, wave upon wave of German bombers dropped high explosives and firebombs on what were essentially non-military targets. Hitler had declared his intention to reduce the city to a pile of rubble. He very nearly did. The raids were skillfully timed to hit the city when the tide in the River Thames was out and when water supplies would be at their lowest. But the courage of the firefighters amply made up for any shortage of supplies. Anti-aircraft batteries were doing their best to protect the city, but with more than 500 bombers on a single raid, their impact was limited. More to the point was the stoicism of the Londoners themselves. Thousands took to sleeping in the safety of underground stations. They emerged next morning not knowing whether they had homes to go to, nor whether friends and relatives who hadn't joined them below ground had survived. Throughout the 3 months of the Blitz, 20,000 men, women and children were killed, and just over the same number seriously wounded. And yet, in spite of the chaos and destruction, morale remained remarkably high. There was no sign of large-scale looting, and crime was at a minimum. Nor had the Londoners lost their cockney humour. A sign in the shattered windows of an East End police station read, "Be good, we're still open." In the end, heroism was the order of the day, as the historic face of London itself was changed forever. Throughout the Blitz, the King and Queen had stayed at Buckingham Palace, which itself was hit by firebombs. Their identification with the suffering of the Londoners did almost as much as Winston Churchill's leadership to inspire the nation to victory.